Many miles from any main road, this beaten path up the side of a West Virginia mountain leads to the home of one of the children in our sponsorship program. This is Curtis and his family, and this is their story.
My name is Curtis, I'm 15 years old. I live deep in the mountains of West Virginia. My house burnt down and we lost everything. My dad was 38 when he died, and he's been dead for about 3 years. It's been rough on us. I miss him a whole lot, and it makes me feel bad.
The fire-ravaged remains of a mobile home are still in the front yard of the shack they now call home. It doesn't have a bathroom, and it's about the size of a storage unit.
The fire was really bad. Whenever I got up, I heard the fire going, so I got up to the bed, got my shoes on, ran outside, and I seen it. Then I ran out there and got my aunt. Then by the time we got out here, it was almost all the way over. Fire department just sprayed the mountainside.
Life on this mountain before the devastating fire was tough enough for a family who had to fight to survive. And now, trying to find the light through this pile of debris has gotten even harder.
I get out here and rag and scrape every dime I can get. I pick up every pop can I find side of the road, every piece of metal. I haul it in maybe $25 or $30. I take it buy some food, web it, gas, buy a young one something when he wants it. We have to go next door to my friends to use the bathroom, take a bath, and stuff like that. I'm trying to get together to get all the stuff I can to build me a bathroom. I've got the tuba sections and stuff like that, but I need tuba fours, tin, and all the plumbing and stuff for the bathroom. I need the commode, bathtub, stuff like that. I can't afford to get none. And a poor man just got a hard way of making it. It's hard to live here like this. And only way, like I said, the only way I can take a bath or use the bathroom in peace is go out to my friends out past me here. My drinking water comes from the old coal seam back of it's been that way ever since I lived here. And my water is like ice, but keeping it running is a problem. You can't hardly keep it running to save your life. You have to fight it every day. I use all my chickens for the family to eat. We give my grandson chops our heads off on a chop block, and we plug them and syringe them with newspapers, and then we bath them good and cut them up, put them in freezer bags, and let the family enjoy them. We fry them, mill and flour, black pepper, salt, make gravy, put on them. And they eat them like a baby eating ice cream. And I've got chicken running everywhere. But I don't ever go to the store and buy chicken.
And we plug them after we put them in hot water, and we swing them, get the hair off of them, then we gut them and everything, and we eat them.
My family enjoys the love, and they love it. I mean, that's the way they're born and raised. They're raised up to eat killed chickens, killed hogs. They enjoy it. That's their life. And I thank God for it. I thank God for another meal every day.
Up here on top of the mountains, it's hard to get food. We have to leave about every week, go get food. It's hard anyways before, now it's really hard. It's hard living here back on the mountain.
Thanks to a generous Anchor Ridge supporter, we were able to deliver a brand new refrigerator to them. Along with the new fridge, we were able to stock them up with groceries, household supplies, clothing, fans, and other wonderful gifts. I just cried as they told me the stories about how hard it was, even if they wouldn't have never had the fire was made it extra bad, but if they had never even had the fire, life was just bad. They were living in a mobile home and they were already building this shack. A church group had already started it and got it going, and because the roof was falling in their mobile home. And so, but they got this, there's no bathroom. And I just made up in my mind, made up in my heart while we were standing in that driveway that day. I said, God, I do not know how to build a bathroom. I don't know the first thing about it, but I do know a lot of people and I know a lot of God. godly people. And you know what? What I've seen lately, God's people have been jumping to be first in line to help out the people of God. And so, you know what? If that's you, if you want to get involved in this project, we're going to build these people a bathroom. We don't have any of it yet. We need 2x4s. We need piping and plumbing. We need a hot water heater. We need a sink. We need a toilet. We need a shower. We need it all. We need tin for the roof. And so if you know anything about building a bathroom, you can come up and help us build it. We're going to raise this money. If you want to buy one of the items, I can meet you up at the Wilkesboro Lowe's. If you're from out of town, you can call the Lowe's, or you can go online or call the Lowe's in Wilkesboro, North Carolina, and just tell them you want to buy a sink or buy a toilet or buy a shower, and you want Josh Paul from Anchor Ridge Ministries to go pick it up, and I will go up there and pick it up, and we're going to document this whole thing. I'm going to let you guys see the difference you're making, and we're going to make a difference in the life of this family. You know, I can imagine not just being able to wake up in the morning and take a shower before I go to work. You know, they got to go down to the neighbors, and you know, what if the neighbors aren't home? Or I just can't imagine living that way. And there's hardly any food up there. There's hardly any hope up there. And you guys, we can show up in these people's situation. Let's do it in the name of Jesus. Come on, go to anchornow.org, anchornow.org. Let's make a difference for this family. Call me. It's 1-800-722-8714. Let's get this bathroom built for this family. Let's show them that the love of God is real, that He is just alive as ever, and the people of God can come together and cause a miracle to happen for this family. And so we love you guys. Keep praying for this ministry.